Hey guys, and we are back playing some more Mass Effect 2. In this episode, we have got some stuff to do, but the first thing that takes priority is customizing my armor. Because we can't just go around like this all the time. I mean, yes, it's badass, but this is an RPG. We want to customize our stuff, so I believe I have some DLCs installed, so let's take a look what we got. I do have the Cerberus Assault Armor. I mean, it's not too bad. I think if you could take your helmet off, I think it'd be fine. But you can't take the helmet off, so we're not going to go with that. Okay, helmet. Don't want a helmet. I have the Kestrel helmet. That's kind of stupid. I don't like that. Chest plate. What do we have? I have the Kestrel torso sheath. Okay. I think they're a little bit too big. I'm going to switch back to the M7. Okay. Gauntlets. What do we have? Kestrel gauntlets, okay, and the Kestrel power pack. Okay, let's see what they actually do. Increase shields by 8% and increase heavy weapon ammo capacity by 5. What does the M7 do? Shield strength by 3. Okay, I think in terms of, you know, efficiency, then I think we're going to have to go with these. Let's scroll down, see what else we got. Material. It really doesn't matter. It doesn't make that much of a difference. Colour. What colour should we have it? Pink, obviously. No. I don't know. What colour should we have them? I think the actual all black looks cool. I might go with that. In fact, I'm not really liking the way these legs look. I might change them. Should we have some red, white, or blue? I think we'll have blue. I just wish we could get rid of that shoulder piece that's got the red M7 on it. Yeah. I don't know why that doesn't change colour with the rest of the armour. Switch to the Kestrel. Yeah, basically we're in Kestrel armor without the helmet. I think that looks fine though. We'll go with that. What else can we do? Change the pattern. What should we do with that? Nah, I think the pattern was fine as it was. No need to faff around with that. Pattern colour. Nope. No need to faff around with that. Okay. New armor. There it is. I'm sure it'll grow on me. I'm not a massive fan of the leg section though, but I can change that. Anyway, let's head in and talk to the elusive man.
Commander Shepard.
Elusive man. I thought we'd be meeting face to face.
Unnecessary precaution. Not unusual for people who know what you and I know.
You might be the reason I'm still alive, but that doesn't mean I trust you.
You need to put your personal feelings aside. Humanity is up against the greatest threat of our brief existence.
The Reapers.
Good to see your memory still intact. How are you feeling?
You need to earn the right to ask me those kinds of questions.
Cerberus isn't as evil as you believe. You and I are on the same side. We just have different methods.
Cut to the chase. What are the Reapers doing that made you decide to bring me back?
We're at war. No one wants to admit it, but humanity is under attack. While you've been sleeping, entire colonies have been disappearing. Human colonies. We believe it's someone working for the Reapers. Just as Saren and the Geth aided Sovereign. You've seen it yourself. You bested all of them. That's just one reason we chose you.
Nothing you say is going to convince me to trust you. I need more than words.
I'd be disappointed if I could persuade you that easily. Go and see for yourself. I have a shuttle ready to take you to Freedom's Progress, the latest colony to be abducted. Miranda and Jacob will brief you.
Is this a volunteer job, or am I being volunteered?
You always have a choice, Shepard. If you don't find the evidence we're both looking for, we can part ways. But first, go to Freedom's Progress. Find any clues you can. Who's abducting the colonies? Do they have any connection to the Reapers? I brought you back. It's up to you to do the rest.
Level 3 already. And we haven't even done anything yet. Alright. Looks as though we are heading to Freedom's Progress. I might talk to Miranda a little bit more. Why not?
The elusive man is very impressed with you. I'm eager to see if you can live up to his expectations on this mission.
I never got a chance to say how much I appreciated what the Lazarus Project did for me.
I just hope it was worth it. A lot of people lost their lives on that station.
We have to work together here. Your attitude isn't helping anything.
I have the utmost respect for your abilities, Shepard. It's your motivations that concern me. I believe in what Cerberus stands for. Only time will tell if you prove to be an asset or a liability to our cause.
What can you tell me about this colony we're going to?
Freedom's Progress? It's a typical human settlement in the Terminus systems. They had a small military force for protection supplemented by mechs and security drones. Average in almost every way, really. Completely unremarkable. Until the disappearance.
Any thoughts on what we might run into there?
A lot of empty buildings and one giant mystery.
I'd like to know more about the Lazarus Project from the person in charge.
I wasn't in charge. The elusive man was. If I was running the show, would have done a few things differently.
What would you have changed?
To start, I would have implanted you with some type of control chip. But the elusive man wouldn't allow it. He was afraid it might affect your personality, alter your character somehow. He wouldn't let us do anything that might limit your potential in any way.
Can't say I like the idea of being brought back to life with a control chip in my brain.
The elusive man is taking an incredible risk with you. I just hope his gamble pays off.
You're not doing much to make me like you, Miranda.
Tell me a little about yourself.
Just saying.
Worried about my qualifications? I can crush a mech with my biotics or shoot its head off at 100 yards. Take your pick.
Did you and Jacob serve together in the Alliance?
No. The elusive man recognized my potential and recruited me at a young age.
How old were you?
Old enough to know this is what I wanted.
I was trying to get to know you as a human being.
I'm not looking for a friend, Shepard. Stay focused on the mission.
Fine.
It's obvious you're not interested in talking.
We've got an assignment. We can talk about it or we can do it.
Bitch. Jacob! Hello.
I'm glad the elusive man convinced you to join us, Commander.
I just want to find out what happened to those missing people. I still don't trust Cerberus.
Noted. Do you trust me, Commander?
I haven't made up my mind about you yet.
At least you're giving me a chance. Most Alliance soldiers hate Cerberus on principle.
Do you know anything about this colony we're going to?
It's called Freedom's Progress. Don't know much else. I guess we'll find out when we get there.
You said you served in the Alliance?
5 years in total. Stationed all over the galaxy. Even spent a couple of years as a Corsair.
I've never heard of the Corsairs.
It was an Alliance initiative. They hired independent starship captains and used them for missions that fell outside official Alliance jurisdiction. Technically, we weren't part of the Alliance. If we ever got caught, they could disavow any knowledge of us. We were supposed to be free from restrictions and rules. But there was still enough red tape to sink a cruiser. I finally just gave up.
Why did you join Cerberus?
I guess I just got tired of never making a difference. So much of what we did in the Alliance seemed pointless. I thought things would change after the attack on the Citadel. The old council was dead, and humanity took control of the new one. But nothing changed. Politics, bureaucracy, same bullshit, different leaders. Cerberus is different. When colonies go missing, we don't commission a team to write a report to figure out what the hell to do about it. We just go and find out.
That's all for now.
Yes, sir.
12 Paragon. Plus 4. Alright. Let's head to Freedom's Progress. The loading screens on this game seem to take much longer than Mass Effect 1, for some reason, on my PC.
We should be there shortly, Shepard. The elusive man put us under your command. Do you have any orders?
Her first priority is to look for survivors.
That's unlikely, Commander. No one was left at the other colonies. They were completely deserted.
Be nice to find somebody. Anything's better than another ghost town.
Okay, what weapons do I now have? I've got an assault rifle, so let's equip that. Oh, they've given me all the basic weapons. That's annoying. Let's put the sniper rifle as well. See, I normally play sort of as a hybrid of the soldier and the infiltrator. I tend to use sniper rifles a lot and assault rifles a lot. And I very rarely use powers. Except for the ammo powers, of course. God fucking hell, why won't it just... Never mind. God, the more time I spend fucking around with the weapons... Okay, let's see what we got.
Strange. No bodies, no structural damage, and no signs of battle.
Nope. Some spare parts. Got 1,000 credits just from some spare parts. Kinda cool. Oh, we've got next.
Enemies! Shoot them before they take out your shield.
Fuck. There we go.
They should have recognized us as human.
Someone reprogrammed them to attack on sight. We're not alone here.
We are not alone out here. Okay. Let's find some stuff. Got a wall safe over there and a medkit. Let's take that. Let's hack this. No problem. Credits. Awesome. Alright.
They've seen us.
Where are they? Oh.
Come on over.
Fucking mechs. I swear to God, you spend most of your time on this game fighting mechs. Quarians.
Stop right there!
Fraza, you said you'd let me handle this. Wait. Shepard?
Hello,
Talia. I'm not taking any chances with Cerberus operatives.
Put those weapons down! Shepard? Is that... you're alive?
Cerberus rebuilt me, Tally. In return, they asked me to investigate these attacks on human colonies.
You'll pardon us for not taking you at your word, Cerberus.
We're well within our rights to investigate attacks on a human colony. I'd like to know what the Quarians are doing here.
Weapons down, Fraza. Whatever's going on here, I don't think we need another fight. One of our people was here on pilgrimage. His name was Vitor. We came to find him.
Isn't that a little strange? A Quarian visiting a remote human colony?
Quarians can choose where they go on pilgrimage. Vitor liked the idea of helping a small settlement. He was always nervous in crowds.
She means that he was unstable. Combine that with damage to his soot CO2 scrubbers and an infection from an open-air exposure, and he's likely delirious.
When he saw us landing, he hid in a warehouse on the far side of town. We suspect he also programmed the mechs to attack anything that moved.
Vitor's the only one who can tell us what happened here. We should work together to find him.
Good idea. You'll need two teams to get past the drones anyway.
Now we're working with Cerberus?
No, Praza, you're working for me. If you can't follow orders, go wait on the ship. Head for the warehouse through the center of the colony. We'll circle around the far side and draw off some of the drones to clear you a path.
Your people really don't like Cerberus. What did I miss?
They killed our people, infiltrated our flotilla, and tried to blow up one of our ships.
That's not how I'd have explained it exactly. It was nothing personal.
We can argue over who killed who later. Right now, we've got a job to do.
Agreed. We work together to get to Vitor.
Make sure to keep in radio contact.
Will do. Good luck, Shepard. See you on the far side.
Alrighty. Let's move.
Be careful, Shepard. There's a squad of security drones up ahead.
Thanks for the warning.
Oh, by the way, in case you hadn't already gathered, I am playing this as a Paragon Shepard.
We've been spotted.
Just like I did with the, Yeah. Just like I did with the original. Paragon's the way to go. In my opinion. Ah, shit. Right. Fuck! God, I hate the hacking minigame so much. How the hell did I manage to fuck that up? God. Sorry, I'm blowing into the microphone. Let me just adjust that a little bit.
Use overload on him.
Who the fuck's got overload? I think Miranda's got overload.
You're done.
Wait, if we're gonna be fighting these things, I have disrupt ram. That might be more helpful.
Drop.
Shepard, Praza and his squad rushed on ahead. I told them to wait, but they wouldn't listen. They want to find Vitor and take him away before you get here.
We should have expected this.
Come on, we can still catch them.
Fucking take cover. No, not there.
Hurry, Shepard. We're inside the loading docks. Vitor reprogrammed the heavy mech. It's tearing Praza's squad apart.
They did want to get to Vitor first.
Get your squad into cover and I'll open the loading bay doors.
We'll take cover by the doors. Shepard, you take point.
Okay, Q and E.
On it.
Going to cover.
Well, damn. Overkill much.
Mech's got heavy armor plating. Those Quarians never stood a chance.
This is gonna be one tough son of a bitch to take down.
No, it's not. Yeah, but considering the fact that I've got disrupt ammo,
here we go.
Got overload. Let me switch to your armor piercing. Oh, at least he's running from around that way. Okay, teamwork, guys. Nice work. Okay, I really did all of it, but there we go. Okay, where am I heading? Wait, let's just explore up here what we got. Tally.
This is your chance to go find Vitor while I tend to the wounded, Shepard. He's probably somewhere in the back of the loading bay.
Okie dokie. Let me just see what's in this building across here. Power cells, excellent. Right, let's see if I can fuck this up. Yay, I did it. Too pro. Not really, but there we go. Let me switch to my sniper rifle. Just because I can. There we go.
This should come in handy.
Finally managed to get the weapon switch down.
Monsters coming back. Mechs will protect. Safe from swarms. Have to hide. No monsters. No swarms. No, 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 no.
Vitor?
No, Vitor. Not here. Swarms can't find. Monsters coming. Have to hide.
Nobody's gonna hurt you anymore.
I don't think he can hear you, Commander.
Have to hide. Have to hide.
Paragon.
You're human. Where did you hide? How come they didn't find you?
Who didn't find us?
The monsters. The swarms. They took everyone.
Why didn't the colonists fight back, Vitor? What happened?
You don't know. You didn't see. But I see everything.
Looks like security footage. He must have pieced it together manually.
What the hell is that?
My god. I think it's a collector.
Is that some kind of alien?
They're a species from somewhere beyond the Omega 4 relay. Only a few people have ever seen one in person.
They usually work through intermediaries, like slavers or hired mercenaries. If they're involved with the Reapers somehow, it could explain what happened to the colonies.
The collectors have advanced technology. They could have a weapon that disables an entire settlement at once.
The Seeker swarms. No one can hide. The Seekers find you, freeze you, then the monsters take you away.
Why didn't the collectors take you?
Swarms didn't find me. Monsters didn't know I was here.
The collectors aren't known for being careless. Maybe his enviro suit kept him from showing up on their sensors.
Or they were using technology specifically designed to detect humans. Only human colonies have been hit.
Tell me more about these swarms.
It's how they find you. Seeker clouds, machines like tiny insects. They go everywhere. They find you, then they sting you, freeze you.
Sounds like miniature probes, maybe. Find victims, then immobilize them with a stasis field or nerve toxin.
I want to know more about the collectors.
Nobody knows much. They're so rare, a lot of people don't even believe they exist.
More importantly, why are they abducting human colonists? What are they after?
Maybe the elusive man can figure it out.
What happened next?
The monsters took the people onto the ship, and then they left. The ship flew away. But they'll be back for me. No one escapes.
I think that's probably all we're getting out of him, Commander.
We appreciate what you told us. You were very helpful.
I studied them. The monsters. The swarms. I recorded them with my Omni tool. Lots of readings. Electromagnetic. Dark energy.
We need to get this data to the elusive man. Grab the quarry and call the shuttle to come pick us up.
What? Vitor is injured. He needs treatment, not an interrogation.
We won't hurt him. We just need to see if he knows anything else. He'll be returned unharmed.
Your people tried to betray us once already. If we give him to you, we'll never get the intel we need.
Praza was an idiot, and he and his men paid for it. You're welcome to take Vitor's Omnitool data, but please, just let me take him.
He's traumatized and he needs medical care. Tally will give us the Omnitool data and take him to the flotilla.
Understood, Commander.
Thank you, Shepard. I'm glad you're still the one giving the orders. Good luck out there. If I find anything that can help you, I'll let you know.
We're ready for pickup.
Shepard, good work on Freedom's Progress. The Quarians forwarded their findings from Vitor's debriefing. No new data. but it's a surprising olive branch given our history. You and I have different methods, but I can't argue with your results.
You ever think about playing nice once in a while?
Diplomacy is great when it works, but difficult when everyone already perceives you as a threat. But more importantly, you confirm the Collectors are behind the abductions.
Why do I get the feeling you knew about them already?
I had my suspicions, but I needed proof. The Collectors are enigmatic at best. They periodically travel to the Terminus systems, looking to gather seemingly unimportant items or specimens, usually in exchange for their technology. When their transactions are complete, they disappear as quickly as they arrived, back beyond the unmapped Omega 4 relay. Until now, we've had no evidence of direct aggression by the Collectors.
Why is the Omega 4 relay unmapped? What do we know about it?
Only that no ship passing through it has ever returned. Our best guess is that the relay reacts differently to Collector vessels, allowing them safe passage. If they can manipulate relays, that's just further evidence of the connection with the Reapers.
Any ideas on why they've shifted their focus to humans?
If they're agents for the Reapers, it could be any number of reasons. Obviously, humanity played a huge role in Sovereign's destruction. That might have been enough to draw their attention. What really concerns me is why they bother abducting the colonists. Once the humans are paralyzed, why not just kill them?
What are the Collectors getting from these deals?
The Collectors aren't very forthcoming about their motives. Generally, they seek out species with rare genetic mutations or abnormalities. They pay slavers and merc groups exorbitant sums to obtain these specimens, and then they leave. But they've never targeted a single species before, and the previous sample sizes were in the dozens, not the tens of thousands.
You're holding something back. How do you know the Reapers are involved?
The patterns are there, buried in the data. The Consul and the Alliance want to believe the Reaper threat died with Sovereign. You and I know better. I won't wait until the Reapers are on the march. We need to take the fight to them.
If this is a war, I'll need an army. Or a really good team.
I've already compiled a list of soldiers, scientists, and mercenaries. You'll get dossiers on the best of them. Finding them and convincing them to work with you could be challenging, but you're a natural leader. I'll continue to track the Collectors. When they make their next appearance, I'll notify you and your team. Be ready.
Keep your list. I want people I trust. The ones who helped me stop Saren and the Geth.
That was 2 years ago, Commander. Most of them have moved on, or their allegiances have changed.
Where's Liara Tassoni?
She's on Ilium. My sources say that she's working for the Shadow Broker. If so, she can't be trusted.
What about Tali? She already helped us on Freedom's Progress.
That was unexpected. I need more intel before I'll commit to that.
Where's Erdnot Rex?
He returned to Chichanka, and he hasn't gone off-world in over a year. He's trying to unite the Krogan clans.
Where's Caden Olenko?
He's still with the Alliance. Promoted, I believe. His file is surprisingly well classified.
Where's Garrus Vakari?
The Turian disappeared a few months after you were declared dead. Even we haven't been able to locate him.
Oh, I suspect Garrus is up to some badass stuff.
Okay, I get it. They're not available.
You're a leader, Shepard. You'll get who you need.
I'm still a Spectre. Maybe I can get the Council to help us out.
If you think you can convince them, by all means. Just remember, you've been gone a long time. Things have changed.
You worry about the Collectors. I'll make sure my team's ready.
Good. Two things before you go. First, head to Omega and find Morden Solas. He's a brilliant Solarian scientist. Our intelligence suggests he may know how to counteract the Collectors' paralyzing Seeker swarms.
Sounds good. What else?
I've found a pilot I think you might like. I hear he's one of the best. Someone you can trust.
Finally, a familiar face.
Hey, Commander. Just like old times, huh?
I can't believe it's you, Joker.
Look who's talking. I saw you get spaced.
Got lucky, with a lot of strings attached. How'd you get here?
It all fell apart without you, Commander. Everything you stirred up, the Council just wanted it gone. The team was broken up, record sealed, and I was grounded. The Alliance took away the one thing that mattered to me. Hell yeah, I joined Cerberus.
You really trust the Elusive Man?
Well, I don't trust anyone who makes more than I do. But they aren't all bad. Saved your life. Let me fly. And there's this. They only told me last night.
Oh, yes. I love this scene. It's really, really cool.
It's good to be home, huh, Commander?
I guess we'll have to give her a name.
Awesome. New Normandy. Always a good thing. Loading screens. Hurry up. At least the loading screens are more interesting besides just a mass relay spinning around like on Mass Effect 1. Well, this all looks similar.
Welcome aboard the new Normandy, Commander.
I've been looking over the dossiers. I'd strongly recommend starting by acquiring Morden Solus, the Solarian professor on Omega. We know the Collectors use some type of advanced technology to immobilize their victims. We'll need him to develop a countermeasure to protect us.
Without that countermeasure, we'll be helpless if we ever run into the Collectors.
Acquiring Professor Solus seems like the most logical place to start.
Who are you?
I am the Normandy's artificial intelligence. The crew like to refer to me as Edie.
Helmsmen aren't happy when someone takes control of a ship away from them. Especially Joker.
I do not helm the ship. Mr. Moreau's talents will not go to waste. During combat, I operate the electronic warfare and cyber warfare suites. Beyond that, I cannot interface with the ship's systems. I observe and offer analysis and advice. Nothing more.
I'm guessing it takes more than just the three of us plus Joker to fly this ship.
The Normandy has a full crew. They're at their stations awaiting your orders.
Final preparations for takeoff are complete, Commander. When you're ready to go, just pick a destination from the galaxy map and the CIC and I'll plot a course.
Jacob and I should return to our posts. Come find us if you have any questions.
Yep, we've got the galaxy map. I know. Private terminals, yep. I got it. Played this game a million times before. Okay guys, welcome to the Normandy SR2. Anyway, I'm going to wrap up the episode here. So, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care.